TheoTrade. This is Don Kaufman. September 14th, 2020. Minutes to go to the cash close here on this Monday afternoon with the quintessential rip your face off rally. Spoos are flying right now by a whopping 60 points. The Nasdaq futures on fire. Okay, 2.25%. And look out, the little engine that could. The Russell is even playing to this, up some 3%. But what all traders should be questioning right here, right now, is this rally to be sold into? I mean, should you come in and should you sell this market rally? In the next few moments, I'm actually going to show you a couple of reasons why the rally that you're seeing today is just that. It's a quintessential rip your face off rally, which is vastly different, if you would, than people coming in there and going like, wow, I really need to buy this marketplace. I just can't wait to, you know, throw more money into it. What I'm getting at with this, okay, isn't necessarily a big bearish connotation, but what you have to understand about the price action that we are seeing today, it's not what we saw, okay, over the past couple of months. It's especially, okay, very, very far gone from this kind of gamma squeeze to the upside. Again, let me explain why today's rally really is much more of a relief rally. Of course, that could turn into real buy side activity, but what looms large and what is really striking to me are a couple of points that I'm going to get into right now. First and foremost, okay, one of the things that I look at, and it's essential to understand this, advanced decline line. Now, I'm not here to talk to you about, you know, oh, there's a falling advanced decline line. All I'm here is to show you right now the contrast from the last few months, even the last few weeks, the contrast that you're seeing inside of the S&P 100 advanced decline line. Now, there's what we call correlation coefficient, and this, okay, this is a rally that we're absolutely unequivocally correlated. You know, when you have 93 stocks on one side of the marketplace, that's it. It's full-blown correlation. Now, if you remember back, or if you've been watching any of the videos that I've done over the last couple of weeks, couple of months, correlation, it wasn't there in the midst of a rally. Okay? It didn't need to be there, because I'll tell you what. When we rallied a few weeks ago, all you had to do was have Apple rip into the upside. You had to have Amazon rip into the upside, okay? Any of these monsters of tech, if they took off to the upside, well, that's it. That's it, you know, that was a rally. And at the exact same time over the last couple of months, take a look. What have the financials done? Absolutely nothing. Take a look at something like emerging markets, okay? Just drifting listlessly to the upside. All of those factors, okay, are completely different today. So that's one of the first things, okay, as a trader, you have to pick up on, okay, or you're missing some of the bigger picture. What I'm getting to here is correlation is present. And because correlation is present, right, that is an indication that this is a vastly different marketplace than we have traded in. Again, in any of the recent weeks or months, that this is initially, okay, kind of that quintessential, let's just buy, you know, and what? Recover a little bit here. It is a little bit of a relief rally. It is, again, that quintessential rip your face off rally that traders constantly discuss. The second point to be made here, this rally today, it isn't being generated by tech. Sure, you see what? The Nasdaq, Don, it's up 2.3%. It is, okay? However, some of the key players in the marketplace, does this look like much of a bounce in Microsoft? No. Apple, all right, you got me here. Decent bounce, but the sell side activity in there, people, this thing hasn't bounced yet. It has been vicious inside of Apple and sustaining a 3.4%. Netflix is obviously off in the day. Facebook can't get out of its own way. It's actually been sliding back down throughout the course, okay? Amazon's gone negative. Google, massively unchanged. This is not the same players, okay? What you have leading the rally today, well, ironically, could start here in the emerging markets. It's a big gap to the upside. You know, emerging markets, again, they don't often have, you know, 1% and 2% moves. And we're right there. Emerging markets is playing into this. There hasn't been an uptick inside of energy now in literally like weeks. You've had like one decent, maybe two decent up days inside of energy literally in weeks. Okay. The Russell. Have you looked at the Russell lately? It is on fire today after, again, being completely flat. So the drivers of this marketplace, okay, are not the same players that were in the game a few weeks ago. And again, that's one of the larger tells of the market. So then, of course, you're going to ask, well, then how is the Nasdaq flying up 2.4%? Because there are a handful of players in here. Stocks like NVIDIA, right? NVIDIA, again, gapped open this morning predominantly because of news. It's a $30 move to the upside. It's over 6%. But NVIDIA has enough of a market cap that this absolutely is making a dent to the upside inside of the Nasdaq. Okay. If we took a look at something like financials, and I was mentioning this a moment ago, and the financials are up 1.6%. But the reality is that's the XLF. If you take a look at the financials on a percentage basis, they're actually faring much better than you would expect. Here's Bank of America. Here's JP Morgan up some 2%. Citi is dragging the financials down a little bit, specifically the XLF. But this is a little bit of a one-off. This has to do with, well, how they're managing risk right now. But the stock is down 5%. Nevertheless, the financials, generally speaking, are driving a lot of the rally inside of the S&P 500. The point, okay, and in summation, you have to look at isn't just the S&P futures. You got to look at the correlation and know that that hasn't been there. Correlation has only kicked in, okay, when we started getting volatile. So what do you surmise out of this? All of this volatility, this is just more volatility to the upside. At this point in time, okay, you're on just that. You are on borrowed time. At a time like this, okay, I'm not going to rush in with capital. I'm not going to rush in capital and short the market on the first snap bid to the upside. I'm going to let fly a little bit. I might miss the opportunity to short the market. And when I say short the market, where am I going to go? Could I go directly into the QQQ? Absolutely, unequivocally, yes. But the Qs, they don't even look like they've bounced yet. Could I come rushing into the spiders and short those? The same thing. They just don't look like they've bounced yet. I'm more apt to come into stocks like a Tesla that has had that rip your face off rally. Because I'm going to tell you something. If the market is going to feel more sell side activity, it's going to be felt in Tesla as well. Listen, at this point, to answer the question, should I sell the rally? Yes. But let's actually wait. Let's see if another decent sized bid can come under the market tomorrow. Okay. After the bell, yeah, if this thing is up, I'm definitely going to start to execute into some in-out, some bearish in-out spreads, to be specific, possibly in Tesla, and a handful of other products here that have really extended themselves quite a decent amount, again, in what looks to be just a momentary, you know, breather, if you will, to the upside. With that, thanks everybody here for joining us at TheoTrade. Have a wonderful evening. Bye-bye.